हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द केमिस्ट्री एंड बायोसिंथेसिस ऑफ टेस्टोस्टेरोन। फर्स्ट कमिंग टू द जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द टेस्टोस्टेरोन, इट इज़ द प्रिंसिपल हार्मोन ऑफ द टेस्टिस, ओके, एंड इट इज 19 कार्बन स्टेरॉइड रिंग विथ OH ग्रुप प्रेजेंट एट 17th पोजिशन। ओके, दिस इज द जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द टेस्टोस्टेरोन। नाउ कमिंग टू द सिंथेसिस ऑफ द टेस्टोस्टेरोन, इट इज सिंथेसाइज फ्रॉम कोलेस्ट्रॉल। कोलेस्ट्रॉल कन्वर्टेड इंटू प्रेग्नेनोन बाय 20-22 डेस्मोलेज एंजाइम। ओके, एंड आफ्टर कन्वर्टिंग टू प्रेग्नेनोन, इट विल कन्वर्ट टू 17 अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सी प्रेग्नेनोन बाय द एंजाइम नोन एज 17 अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सिलेज। ओके, एंड दिस 17 अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सी प्रेग्नेनोन विल कन्वर्ट इंटू डाइहाइड्रो एपिएंड्रास्टेरोन्स, इज कॉल्ड ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज DHEA। ओके, डाइहाइड्रो एपिएंड्रास्टेरोन, and this will convert into androstenedione. This DHEA is converted into androstenedione, okay, and this will again convert into, and this will leads to the formation of testosterone. Androstenedione will convert into testosterone, and in some tissue, in some cells also, this testosterone is converted into dihydrotestosterone by the enzyme known as 5 alpha reductase, as we will discuss in more detail in mechanism of action of the testosterone about 5 alpha reductase. So testosterone in some tissues will convert it into dihydrotestosterone by enzyme known as 5 alpha reductase. Basically 5 alpha reductase has two forms, 1 and 2, we will discuss in later on. So this is all about the biosynthesis of the testosterone, starting from cholesterol to dihydroepiandrosterone, and then androstenedione, and then testosterone. Okay, now moving to the next part of this, how the synthesis of this testosterone occurs. Testosterone synthesis is under the control of LH hormone. Okay, LH come and bind to the receptors present on the Leydig cells. Okay, LH come and binds to the receptors on the Leydig cells, and it will lead to the activation of GPCR, G protein coupled receptor, and particularly of G stimulatory type, because G protein coupled receptors has three types: G stimulatory, GQ, and GI. And once G stimulatory type activated, it will lead to the activation of adenylate cyclase, which will convert ATP into CAMP. Okay, and ATP it converted into CAMP. Okay, and this CAMP will lead to the activation of protein kinase A. Now coming to the function of CAMP and protein kinase, CAMP will convert cholesterol ester into cholesterol. And because cholesterol is needed for the synthesis of testosterone, as we have discussed earlier, and this cholesterol is converted into pregnenolone by the stimulatory effect of protein kinase A. Cholesterol is converted into pregnenolone by enzyme 20-22 desmolase, and 20-22 desmolase is stimulated by protein kinase A. Okay, so this is the basic mechanism of the regulation of synthesis of testosterone by LH. Okay, so secretion of testosterone is under the control of LH, and it works through GPCR, that is the G stimulatory pathway. Now moving to the transport and metabolism of the testosterone. Generally 95 to 98% of testosterone in plasma is bound to protein, and it is basically divided into two parts. 65% bind to GBG. What is GBG? Gonadal steroid binding globulin, and remaining 33% bind to albumin. Okay, 65% binding to GBG, that is gonadal steroid binding globulin, and 33% is binding to albumin. Now, the circulating testosterone in a small amount will be converted into estradiol. Okay, this small amount is here. A small amount of circulating testosterone is converted into estradiol, but maximum part is metabolized into 17 ketosteroids, and two examples of 17 ketosteroids are given here: androsterone and itiocolanone. This is the isomer of androsterone. Okay, itiocolanone is just isomer of androsterone, and it is excreted in urine. So these are these two are the basic metabolic product of the circulating testosterone, which is released into urine. Okay, so this is all about the metabolism.